Hey, buddy, I got a Tesla update for you. Here's my Tesla P100D. Quick garage update for those who don't know what I currently have. We got the old 4 GT, the new 4 GT, the Huracan, 720S, and my Tesla P100D here. This car I've had for 28 months. And it's got 37,000 miles on the car. So 28 months and 37,000 miles. This is probably the most miles I've had in a car in a very long time. Typically, I upgrade once a year or when something newer or faster comes out, but literally, Tesla hasn't done anything in 28 months. This is one of the first P100Ds that came out. For those of you who aren't familiar with my Tesla history, this is actually my fifth Tesla Model S. I started off with a 2012 silver P85. Traded that for a red P85. When the P85D came out, I immediately traded up to that. I had a black P85D. When the P90D came out, I traded up for that. And then when the P100D came out, I traded up for that. But Tesla hasn't increased performance for a really, really long time. There just hasn't been a reason for me to upgrade until possibly now. So recently, Tesla refreshed the Model S, or a slight refresh. They did renaming, so they don't call them by numbers anymore. There's no 75, 90, 100. Now they call them standard range, long range performance, and then you can get long range performance with ludicrous. And they updated the drivetrain, at least in the performance model that has the optional $20,000 ludicrous package, and it allows for more range and an additional. Well, supposedly additional performance, and we really didn't know if that was going to happen until now. So Eli from My Tesla Adventure just took delivery of his long-range performance with ludicrous and took it out to the drag strip last week and set a new record with hitting a 1061 at 127.5 miles an hour. So when I saw that, I was all over it. I'm like, wow, here we go. Some really good numbers. I took a look at his time slip, compared it to my time slip from when I first got my car, and I ran a 1076 at about 123 miles an hour. So that is a significant increase in power on the top end and a pretty good drop in the ET as well. By looking at this time slip, I kind of felt like there's a little more in it. He ran the original 1061 last week on the 19-inch wheels. I felt like if he went with the lighter arachnids, that he would get a little better. He went out and ran yesterday and put the arachnids on his car and ran even better, a 1053 at 125.95 miles an hour. So that's significantly better in my run. And I did some number comparisons. I actually have a V-Box graph up here. He didn't get to 130 miles an hour, so I don't have 60 to 130 numbers, but I do have 100 to 200 kilometer per hour comparisons to do between my P100D when I first got it and his new car. So the numbers for there on, you can actually see in the graph here, actually it looked like my car came off a little harder and then his car starts to pull away. It picked up. He ran the 100 to 200 in 7.57 and my car did 8.19. That is a pretty significant increase in the top end power. Now, what was really intriguing to me is that 127.5 miles an hour. I was kind of comparing that against my Lamborghini Huracan, which does, you know, on a bad day, it'll run 10.8 at 128, 129 miles an hour. Of course, on cooler nights when the performance is better due to the cool air, it's gone as quick as 10.4 at 131 miles an hour. But seeing that the eighth mile was actually even between, I mean, his Tesla was hitting 103 miles an hour, and that's typically what my Huracan does too. So I kind of wanted to see if Tesla solved that top end pulling power. So I pulled up the 100 to 200 of my Huracan, and that was about 6.48. So I think there's still some work to do on the top end. I think it's still going to lose out to the supercars on the top end. So now the question comes to me is it time to upgrade? Because the car is faster, is it time to upgrade my P100D with the new one? And Tesla's got some incentives out there for existing Model S or Model X owners. They're offering a free ludicrous upgrade to the car, which is worth $20,000. So that there was super intriguing for me because I could save the 20 grand, get a new car. You know, mine's one of the first P100Ds, doesn't have the new autopilot, doesn't have the new computer system. I have no dash cam, I have no Sentry mode, I don't have full self-driving. You know, so this car was one of the first ones. I only have autopilot 1.0 in this. Because the rumor is Tesla's going to do a full or more aggressive refresh of the Model S,
putting the Model 3 batteries in this car, along with the updated drivetrain, we could see some more aggressive performance numbers, possibly low 10s, maybe 10.2, 10.3 and a quarter mile. I'm gonna go over the numbers of what I paid for this car, what I can get a new Tesla for, and kind of decide if I'm gonna buy it now or wait for the refresh and go even faster. All right, so here are the numbers back in 2016 when I bought this car. My car, they used to have all the options separate. It came out to $150,700 for this car. Now, currently, if I went and bought the new one, there's not many options. It pretty much includes everything now. It comes out to $124,500, but that includes Ludicrous. They're gonna give me the free Ludicrous, so chop off $20,000. That leaves a brand new loaded Model S, long range, performance, with Ludicrous, full self-driving and everything, coming in at just $104,500. So I buzzed Tesla. I said, what are you gonna give me on trade for this if I was gonna trade this on the new car? Here's what the numbers came out to. So we got $124,500 for the new car, free Ludicrous, so take off $20,000. They offer me $64,000 for my Tesla Model S on trade. That's pretty bad. I paid $150,000, so pretty disappointing there. I mean, I don't know what else you can do. You can get the new car for $100,000. You know, obviously with 37,000 miles, there's a lot of depreciation there. So you take the difference, that's $40,500. You add tax to that, it comes to $43,335. There's still a $3,750 tax rebate. So you take that off, we get a total cost of just under $40,000. To upgrade from my Tesla to the new one and reset with 0 miles. So the question is $40,000 worth it for the faster car, newer autopilot, the Sentry mode, the dash cams, all the new goodies, or is it better just to wait maybe to the end of the year for the updated, totally refreshed Model S? That's something I gotta decide. Let me know in the comments what you think. Should I upgrade now or should I put it off and wait? Is going from whatever I ran 10.7 to 10.5 worth the 40 grand and all the goodies? Let me know. All right, so there you go. We got a new record for the Tesla Model S run by Ela from My Tesla Adventure. I'm gonna put links to his videos of him running the 10.6 and the 10.5 in the description below. Go ahead and check them out. And you can watch him break the records right there. Of course, another thing to consider is they also updated the drivetrain in the Tesla Model X. Now, if the Tesla Model S picked up 2 or 3 tenths and the Model X can do the same, we could have the world's first 10-second SUV. I think there's a good chance when someone gets the new Model X long range performance with Ludicrous and a full battery, I think we could possibly see a 10-second run and take the world record back from the Urus. Because if you saw about a while back, you know, the Tesla Model X finally lost to the Lamborghini Urus. I think the updated drivetrain in the Model X will take that back. If anyone's got a Model X new performance long range Ludicrous, let me know and I can set up a race with the Urus pretty quickly. All right, so that's a wrap. Congrats to Eli with My Tesla Adventure for setting those records at the Tesla Model S. I'm gonna put links in the description so you can watch him run down the drag strip and set those records. Let me know in the comments, should I upgrade now or should I wait for even better times? I'm thinking I'm gonna wait for the refresh, the total refresh, instead of spending the $40,000 now and then them coming out with something in just a couple months and having to upgrade right away to go for those low tens. Thanks for watching.